No, but it's super good to be here. I'm very excited to be back in Ottawa and just back in Canada. I live in the States now, and I really like it down there. I'll tell you that. I really like it. But the frustrating thing is they don't know dick about us. Like, nothing. And, like, you hear that, and then you think, that can't be true. But then you go there, and you're like, that is so true. Like, my first experience with it was I drove down to Los Angeles my first time down there, and I was in the southern United States, and I pull up to a toll booth, okay? And the guy in the toll booth's like, hey, where are y'all from? And I'm like, well, first of all, it's just me. Yeah. I can't speak for the other people you're seeing in my car right now. But I'm from Canada. And he goes, Canada, huh? Beavers. Yeah, no, I waited for more too. That was all he had. He didn't, there was nothing more. That was the extent of his knowledge of Canada. And I was like, wow, even if you don't know much about Canada, you would think you would at least know our main stereotypes, right? Like hockey, snow. Where do you get beavers from, man? How is beavers the first thing that pops? The only way this makes any sense as a scenario is if he was working in his shitty little toll booth and a story broke on the radio about how every beaver in Canada came out of the woods and just started murdering everybody, right? So I had jumped in my car and pulled up to his toll booth having just escaped the rabid beavers, right? Then it makes sense, right? Because then he's like, Canada, huh? Beavers. I'm like, fucking right, beavers. I don't know what happened. They came out of nowhere and just started murdering everybody. Let me in. I got logs. Because you got to save the logs, at least. But, like, does he just do this with every car that pulls up? You know what I mean? He's like, Japan, huh? Ninjas. Boom, man. I am very culturally savvy. I read a book on the Japanese once, and by book I mean fortune cookie. I know shit.